Imagine
every one of us
performing for you.
In your lounge room.
The theatres are closed.
But the internet's open.
On May 11th
at 7 p.m.
Tune into Joshua Robson Productions Facebook page.
So let's turn the lights up.
Hi, this is Stephen Schwartz saying hello from my home in Connecticut, back in the United States. I hope you enjoy this collection of my songs, and I wish us all the best in these crazy times as we continue to support the arts.
Welcome from my living room to yours, live on Facebook. I am James Cutler. I'm just so thankful that you are tuning in to us tonight. Now, the face that you just saw was that of Mr. Stephen Schwartz, and he's one of the main reasons why this show is happening tonight, but more on that in just a moment. This evening, you are in for a real treat. Over the next couple of hours, you are going to have a couple of dozen very, very talented guests dropping into your living rooms via the wonders of Facebook Live. Some of the finest performers in Australian commercial and independent theatre are here, and they are here to entertain you. We have cast members and some lead stars from Shrek, from School of Rock, Come From Away, Billy Elliot, Six the Musical, Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, The Secret Garden, many, many more, and they're all appearing in your living rooms. You have the best seat in the house, so we'd love you to stay with us. Don't go anywhere tonight. We have a jam-packed performance night for you. We cannot wait. Friends, these performers were among the literally thousands and thousands of workers in our industry around Australia whose gigs were cancelled, postponed, or shut down as a result of the coronavirus. Practically overnight, our industry has come to a grinding halt. But not only have we lost current work, but all sort of future work for the foreseeable future has dried up. But not to let the curtain fall completely, we are bringing up the lights on the arts tonight. That's right. The show must go on, as we always say. And we want to do something, and we're going to do it while sending an all-important message, and that is that the arts will be back. Absolutely. We are hopeful. It's going to be a slow road, slow process, but we are doing what we can to ensure that the industry is not forgotten and that it continues to thrive even in these times. We are putting on a happy face tonight, and we're doing what we do best, which is entertaining you. We know you're in for a real treat tonight, so please stay with us all night. We have so much going on, so many great performers coming up. Lucy Maunder, Ben Mingay, Clee Morgan, Todd McKenney, a couple of ladies from Six are going to be here, even one of the young Billy Elliots, plus a few extra goodies thrown in along the way as well. Now, before we go any further, I want to see if we can throw now to Josh Robson, our producer, or at least Glass, our stage manager, if you guys are there, because they are overseeing our tech tonight, just to say g'day to us. Have we got you guys?
Hello.
Josh, okay. Oh, there you are, mate. How you doing?
Yes, good. How are you?
I'm doing fine. I'm super excited for tonight, man.
Yeah, it's going to be fun.
I'm really hoping I don't have to see your face tonight.
I mean, that's the plan of attack. I mean, if you see our face, it probably means that
things have gone awry.
We need to fill some time and fill some space, but hopefully you don't see me or Elise or Jace too often. Right now, we're currently set up in the home. We've got Jace over there, our tech director. We've got Elise, our stage manager, and myself producing. We've got exactly what you would see in a theatre backstage. We're here and we're coaching everyone along the way as best as we possibly can. A direct translation from stage to screen.
Incredible. Just incredible. We're so thankful that that this is happening tonight, and Joshua Robson Productions at the helm. It's going to be an amazing night. Hey.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. So I hope you all enjoy it, and thanks, James, for taking the lead on this one. And one thing I do encourage on our Facebook page, comment and like and share as much as you possibly can. Get the story out there. Especially comment, ask questions, because unlike theatre, you do have the chance to interact with some of our performers and our host tonight. So if you do have a question for one specific performer or anything, we'll do our best to answer that question for you if we can. So yeah, I'll throw it back to James, and hopefully we don't see you again and you don't see this face or these two faces over here again for the rest of the night.
We love your faces, but we don't want to see them anymore because it means that things would have gone a little bit pear-shaped, and that's okay. You guys
will be fine.
You're looking after us. That's the main thing.
Yeah, we'll be fine. Bye-bye. Enjoy tonight. And let's keep those lights up.
You bet we will. Indeed. Bye. Thank you, guys. You're amazing. So tonight, you guys, you're going to be hearing from many, many, many artists. And as is always the case with live performance, making your experience memorable. We all want that thrill of live performance to continue, even in these times. So we ask you to just enjoy yourselves tonight. Treat it as a date night, your night out. Maybe you want to dress up, put some heels on. This is your fill of culture for the night, whatever you want. And look, if you want this live avenue to continue, we would ask you to consider buying a ticket on our GoFundMe page, which I believe you can see it. I have to get the direction right. Is it there or is it there? It's one of those. You can see it anyway. GoFundMe.com/LUOTA, which is Lights Up on the Arts. That would be fantastic. All of our box office monies will be evenly distributed throughout the whole cast tonight, and those offstage as well who are helping to make sure that this whole show comes together and goes off without a hitch. As we continue to make sure that live performance is available and live performers are not lost to Australia. So please sit back and enjoy what we hope will be the first of many live shows for you to attend. Now, I mentioned before that Stephen Schwartz was partly responsible for making tonight possible, and that is very true. You saw him at the beginning of the broadcast, wishing us all well for tonight. Even if you don't know him by name, I'm sure you have heard of some of his music. Stephen Schwartz is one of the greatest composers and lyricists of our generation. He's written musicals such as Godspell, Pippin, Wicked, The Baker's Wife, and animated films such as Pocahontas and The Hunchback of Notre Dame, The Prince of Egypt, which recently premiered in London on the West End at the Dominion Theatre. Of course, it has also fallen victim to Corona, but it is an epic show. And we are very lucky because tonight we are going to be performing a couple of songs from the stage musical of The Prince of Egypt. Stephen Schwartz has very, very kindly given us complete access to his catalogue of music. I'm sure you'll agree that it is a completely stunning body of work. And we're very, very lucky that he's given us access to it. We could not do tonight's show without him. So thank you very much, Stephen, because we know you're watching. So without further ado, I think we should bring up our first guest. She starred last year in Ragtime with the production company. She was in West Side Story and, of course, most recently, Catherine of Aragon in Six. We have Chloe Zuel here, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, Chloe.
Hello, how are you?
I'm so great. It's so good to see you. How are you going?
I'm good. I'm nervous.
Are you? Why? Yeah. It's just you and me talking. Just us.
I'm a little bit out of practice.
It feels like it's been a while. Hey, like you get into isolation and suddenly the weeks have gone past and you're like, when did I last sing?
No, honestly, I forgot. I've sort of forgotten what a musical is.
I'm sure you haven't. Not tonight. Hey, how's your isolation treating you?
It's interesting. It's really quiet, isn't it? You know, I'm taking every day as it comes, but I'm in Tasmania with my husband, who is picking apples. And so I'm just here as an apple picking wife.
you make it sound really romantic, really glamorous.
You know what? Everyone likes to think that it's romantic, so I'll just let everyone feel that way.
Go with the illusion. Absolutely. Hey, so Six, congratulations on that. What, like, an amazing show and so incredibly popular. Those who know it talk about it and know every word already. And you did the Sydney season.
Yep.
How was that?
Oh, it was magic. It's I don't think I quite realized what I was a part of when I started rehearsals for the show, but it is, it's huge. It's a phenomenon. And it's so nice to be a part of that legacy and to be portraying these strong, powerful women, and to be in a cast of women, like 9 women altogether, and most of the people on the show are women. It's really, really special.
It really looks it. And there's so much stuff on social media. You guys have recorded stuff, and there's like all the casts around the world have banded together, and you've created some amazing content.
That was really cool.
It's so good. I wish I had a chance to see it. I was in Sydney at the time with School of Rock, but of course we were obviously performing every night that you were on, so we didn't get to see you. Do we know what's going to happen with the show? Are we hoping it comes back? I hope it will.
I hope it comes back too. I think we're in the same boat as everyone else, and we're just waiting to see what happens. You know, no one really knows what the next steps are. We're just sitting, waiting, wishing, fingers crossed, and hoping for the best.
That's it. Because you had the Melbourne and the Adelaide and the Wellington season announced initially, hadn't you? So you sort of had several months of work planned.
Yep, we really did. And we were actually on break when COVID-19, well, when it all kind of started happening. Yeah. So I think in the back of my mind, I thought, oh, we might just start a week late or something. I was living in some sort of dreamland, clearly. It's really disappointing, but it's such a great show. And it's been postponed, so we'll just see and hope that we come back and everyone comes and supports us.
That's it. We just hope. And there is such a strong sense of hope tonight, isn't there? You know, we're talking about supporting shows. We're all banding together, and hope really is kind of the word that I feel like is hanging over tonight's performance.
Yeah, that's what I think us performers do well, is that, you know, we're so used to being knocked down and having to get back up that we're in a way prepared for this kind of setback. I mean, no one could be prepared for this, but we're used to being knocked down and finding some sort of hope and positivity to keep going and moving forward. So I think that's why we've all come together to do something like this.
You've said it so beautifully. That's exactly right. Hey, Chloe, I want you to sing for us. What are you going to perform?
I'm going to sing Colours of the Wind from Pocahontas.
Love it. I love it. All right. It's all yours. Go for it.
Now, this is going to do a false start, so I'm just going to do it straight up. There we go. This is with the lovely Anthony Barnhill. Think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. Think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Have you ever heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon? Or ask the grinning bobcat why he grinned? Can you sing with all the voices of the mountains? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Come run the hidden pine trails of the forest. Come taste the sun-sweet berries of the earth. come rolling all the riches all around you. And for once, never wonder what they're worth. The rainstorm and the river are my brothers. The heron and the otter are my friends. And we are all connected to each other in a circle, in a hoop that never ends. How high will the sycamore grow? If you cut it down, then you'll never know. And you'll never hear the wolf cry to the blue corn moon. For whether we are white or copper skinned, you need to sing with all the voices of the mountains. We need to paint with all the colors of the wind. You can own the earth and steal. All you'll own is earth until you can paint with all the colors of the wind.
Oh, Chloe, that was absolutely stunning. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah. Oh, pleasure. Hey. Hayden T has a question for you. He's wondering what highlighter you're wearing.
I love Hayden T. I'm wearing a Desi Katie Perkins one from Morphe. Yeah.
I thought so.
Rebecca Selly that she gifted to me because she's a legend.
Hey, Chloe, thank you so much for being here tonight.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
No worries at all. Guys, we have the delightful John O'Hara in next. John O'Hara from School of Rock. How are you, my friend?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm loving tonight already.
Me too. Well done, Chloe.
Right, and you're following that. Hey, you and I met in School of Rock.
We did.
And what a fun time that was. That was about, 16 months or something all up?
Yeah, September 2018.
Right up until our Sydney season, and then, of course, ended before the Adelaide season.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know for a fact that you have done a Stephen Schwartz show before because you did Wicked, didn't you?
Oh yes, just a little bit of Wicked.
A little bit of Stephen Schwartz. And I think you got a funny story to tell me about Wicked. I remember you telling me.
Yeah.
You had something to tell.
So I mean, there were many stories on Wicked because the show went for almost 7 years, I think, from go to woe. I did the final almost 3 years of it. And I joined very quickly. I auditioned, got the job, was on a plane to Singapore to join the company, and was on stage within a week.
Wow.
And so obviously I didn't know the material as well as you'd hope.
And you can forgive him for that. 3 days.
So I had I was put into the show incrementally. But anyway, I played the father at the beginning in the prologue, and there's a little French horn pickup into my line, how I hate to go and leave you lonely. Yeah. Anyway, I went out my first night, and I completely stuffed it up. So I started it 3 times. How I hate to go. Anyway, because Wicked is so popular and in Singapore, especially, it was very, very popular. People filmed it, and it exists on YouTube.
You're kidding. Are you going to link us through to it?
Absolutely not. Go find it. I it's hard to find. It's something Singapore, something.
Like yeah, Australian.
Wicked, I can't remember yet.
Fail yeah. Something.
Yeah. And of course,
I'm
everyone.
Sure find it, no. And they're going to share the link, and we can all enjoy it tonight. Because you're not singing Wicked tonight, so you're off the hook with that one.
Absolutely.
But you are singing a song from the film Geppetto.
Yeah.
Which is like one of those gems. Like no one seems to know this song.
Full disclosure, I'd never heard it. And then when you guys reached out to me, I started listening to the catalogue, and I stumbled across it. And so it's the first time I've ever sung it. And I love it. It's a beautiful little, it's kind of like a lullaby.
It is. And you're sitting in the perfect position for a lullaby.
I'm sitting on the floor in my apartment.
We all do what we can to get through those times. You haven't got up from there in the last 6 weeks, have you?
No.
Got a little bowl of water in the corner and you're just like, good to go.
Yep.
All right. Well, mate, sing us some Geppetto, please.
I will. I will. This is called Since I Gave My Heart Away. You can take my favorite chair. Go on, take it, I don't care. There's no possession I can't spare. Since I gave my heart away. If I had a bank account, you could take the whole amount. Things and riches, what are they? Since I gave my heart away, till I felt like this, I could not have understood. Until you give your heart to someone else, might as well be made of wood. So take my home, look, here's the key, and all the value you might see. But never take your love from me. That's a price I cannot pay. Since I gave my heart away, there's a lesson learned. I learned it late, but no regrets. The more of your heart you give to someone else, the fuller that it gets. So take my home, look, here's the key, and all the value you might see. Never, never take your love from me. That's a price I cannot pay. Since I gave my heart away.
That was lovely.
It's pretty, isn't it? It's a pretty little song. I love it.
It really is. It's just so stunning. Gosh. Oh, you can just go. We'll just put you on repeat tonight.
Again. I know, that'll be going in my repertoire. I'll be singing that at auditions.
That's it. That's exactly it. I'll be performing from my recent triumphant performance on Lights Up at the Arts, reprising my role. Beautiful work, mate. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a lovely night. I'll be watching.
And look after yourself. Stay well.
I will.
Good for you. All right. Next up, we have Ben Mingay from Shrek. Shrek himself is in the house. Ben Mingay, hello, mate. I think we've got him. We have him, don't we? He's on mute. That's all right. This is like classic Zoom territory here. How you doing, mate? There you go. I'm doing good. I feel like you're very, very quiet and very in the distant.
Like, that's because my microphone was set up for the performance, but hello.
Yeah, so it's not going to work over there, is it?
Is that better?
That's so much better. How you keeping? How's isolation going for you?
Yeah, I'm all right, man. It's it's a really bizarre time. I think to go from having sort of gigs booked back to back until March next year to absolutely nothing is bizarre. Like it's really quite shocking to the system. But you know, I mean, it's things like this are coming out, and we're all sort of having to adapt. And artists have always been good at, you know, weathering the storm. So I think this is a really good time for us, you know.
Right. Yeah. And if, you know, if in doubt, just live in an abandoned Bunnings. Is that where?
Well,
where are you?
Yeah, I'm actually in old man's company has this office, and off the side of it is this big warehouse, and I rent a bit of space here. And I don't really want to adjust things too much, but there's a lot of things going on in here.
Yeah. Yeah.
A little bit of advertising, you know, a bit of that.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. yeah. Oh, okay. There's worse places you could be during isolation, I reckon.
This is a bit of a play shed. There's a lot of things out here to fiddle with and fix. I've got a boat, I've got a car, an old motorbike.
A Christmas tree I saw the other night.
Santa Claus is over in a corner there, but I didn't want Santa Claus involved in the actual live performance because I think he cheapens it. And, you know, I've gone to a lot of trouble with my assistant Richie here. So, you know, I think
Santa would do wonders to increase any performance, any time of year. Hey, Ben, I have to tell you, we saw you in Shrek in Sydney, and hats off. What an incredible performance you put in. And the amount of work that it obviously takes just to get on stage night after night, the latex and the green and the everything, it must have been a killer of a show.
Yeah, it was full on. I think, you know, a lot of people ask me that question about Shrek, and it was a massive show, and it was glorious to play that role, and it was such fun. The cast were amazing, you know, Lucy, to work with Lucy and Nat Job and Todd, and it was just amazing. But it was a lot, you know. It was on a two-show day, it was 12 hours or so in the Shrek head, so that's inside that thing with everything that goes on in there for 12 hours. It was a lot.
Yeah,
and big fat suit too. Like it was quite heavy and big clogs, so I was pretty fit by the end of it.
Yeah,
just keep it going.
No doubt. Yeah. And I'm so sorry that it ended because it really deserved to be seen millions of times over. What a show!
You know, the worst thing is, I actually told a lot of people. I said, "Oh, yeah." No, they said, "Well, book tickets to Shrek." I said, "Yeah, well, just book it towards the end of the season in Melbourne, or you know, fly it to Brisbane and see it up there." And now I'm absolutely kicking myself, and so are those people. Well, they want to kick me because they haven't been able to see it.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Hey, you're going to be singing for us in a couple of seconds. Do you want to tell us what you're singing, or are you just going to get yourself in position and go for it?
Well, okay, I'll tell you what I'm singing, because you know, me and Richie here have gone to a lot of trouble. I feel now like we might have overdone it, Rich.
No, absolutely not.
Because we've created a bit of a set here in the shed. So I've got the old four-wheel drive trailer behind me, which we've made sturdy and chocked it up. Richie's put on some key lighting, and we're all set up. So this is full production as COVID goes. So mate, if you're ready, this is Hunchback of Notre Dame. I am in the tower, and yes. I'm Quasimodo. I tried to get Richie to do some makeup on my eye to make it look a bit gangly, but it didn't really work. So we just washed that off. So anyway, yeah, I'm gonna get up in the trailer. Richie's gonna hit the lights. You wanna hit the lights? Lips and. All right, yeah. So because we've only got one assistant, I'm just going to have to make sure this is open. This is fun. Yeah.
And you got Jack Earl, who's accompanied you, and he's an absolute living legend. So,
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
We're in safe hands with yourself and Jack Earl.
He put this track together, and it's really tops.
All right, well, you sort yourself out. Go for it. I can't believe, like, this is what happens. You know, you get Ben Mingay, you take him off the set of Shrek, and you just know that he's not just going to sit in front of it, you know, sit on his couch and sing your song. He's going to go the whole hog.
There's no point doing things in halves.
No, man. That's right.
Yeah. You might have to turn that around a little bit too, Richie, when we get started, because you never know.
Ben, you look amazing. Go for it, buddy.
You wait. You haven't seen anything. Lights?
Safe behind these windows and these parapets of stone, gazing at the people down below me,
All my life I watch them as I hide up here alone, hungry for the histories they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass the day not above them, but part of them. And out there, living in the sun, give me one day out there. All I ask is one to hold forever out there, where they all live on. Aware what I'd give, what I dare, just to live one day out there. Out there amongst the millers and the weavers and their wives, through the roofs and gables I can see them. Every day they shout and scold and go about their lives, heedless of the gift it is to be them. If I was in their skin, I'd treasure every instant out there, strolling by the Seine. Taste a morning out there, like ordinary men who freely walk about there. One day and then I swear I'll be content with my share. Won't resent, won't despair, old and bent, I won't care. I'll have spent one day out there.
That is Ben Mingay. He does not do anything by halves, does he? Champion effort, mate. You're a legend. Thank you so much. Look, it's not just the performers who are impacted. And now we're going to hear from some non-performers from our industry, because we want to acknowledge and give voice to our industry as a whole and highlight how this has affected our entire industry. We don't necessarily see them on stage, but without them, these shows simply would not happen. I'm talking about the producers, the musical directors, the stage managers, and the directors. So here are a handful of them discussing how this pandemic has affected their lives.
Hi everybody, it's John Frost here. I'm actually what they call a theatre producer. So I'm the person that goes out and raises the money, decides on what the show is, helps with the casting, and pays the bills at the end of the day, I suppose. I was lucky because I had the opportunity of working as a dresser, as a wardrobe master, as a assistant stage manager, a stage manager, company manager, and then I ran a little theatre in Sydney called the Marion Street Theatre for a few years, and ran a nightclub, and then I decided it's time for me to be a producer. So when was it? I think 1983 we incorporated the Gordon Frost Organisation.
I'm Laura Topoki and I'm a musical director and musician. Been working in the Australian music theatre industry for around about 12 years.
My name's Elise Glass and I am a stage manager in the commercial musical theatre industry. I've been working in this industry for about 8 years now, and I was stage managing Shrek the Musical when we were closed due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Come that period when we were all told we had to put down tools, it was sort of came as a bit of a shock, and it came as a shock to certainly me, and I know to all the actors and the technicians and the people that I'd employed, because I had like 3.5 shows ready on being Book of Mormon in New Zealand. I had Charlie and the Chocolate Factory about to open in Brisbane. I had Shrek in Melbourne. And we were about to go into rehearsal for 9 to 5. And of course, Secret Garden about to happen and the Yiddish version of Fiddler on the Roof. So this year was going to be Gordon Frost's biggest year. So for somebody to come along and just say, stop, you can't do this anymore, was a bit of a shock, as I'm sure it's been a shock to you. And if you're like me, I can't do anything else. Certainly mentally, it's been frustrating for me, as I'm sure it has for you. Artistically, it's frustrating. Financially, it's very frustrating. But you know, I'm an optimist, and I think that we will all bounce back, and the industry will be a lot stronger and smarter.
I recently have been working as the music supervisor and musical director for School of Rock and the Australasian tour. When the coronavirus saw us and every other show in the country close their curtains indefinitely, it's been a frightening time. It's an uncertain time. Our entire industry disappeared overnight. Actors, musicians, crew, front of house staff, everyone out of work with no income.
Obviously financially I was hit hard by this closure. My husband also works in the entertainment industry, so it meant that we were hit twice as hard. It has meant that it's been a struggle to pay bills and our mortgage, and we are currently dipping into our savings to cover this.
I can say is stick in there and encourage your friends that when we do all go back to work, that they've got to get behind and go to the theatre and buy a ticket. That's really important, because I think the problems that we're going to face is that, particularly with big musicals in this country, unless we're allowed to sell 1,500 to 2,000 seats of performance, we're not going to see any big musicals for a while. Now, if government allows us to do that and relax, you know, the distances between patrons and that, well, that's going to be fantastic, because we will bounce back very quickly. But if not, it's going to be a slow haul for all of us. Anyway, stick in there, everybody, and keep smiling. And I'm here to tell you that the Gordon Frost Organisation and John Frost here have got a filing cabinet full of shows that we want to produce.
I remain hopeful. I'm spending my time with my nearly 1-year-old daughter, Lola, being a mum, cooking, cleaning, playing piano as well, trying to keep my skills up. If you'd like to continue showing your support for the arts, you can do so by listening to our albums, watching our live streams, and when you're able to, get out there and buy tickets to our concerts and our shows once more. We will be back. We'll be stronger and more fierce than we were before. Because in times of hardship, music is what connects us. It's what lifts us. And it's what heals us. Stay safe, stay at home, and support the arts.
When we get back to some kind of normal, I really hope that people get back into supporting the arts and coming to see theatre. I think it's going to be a really important way for people to reconnect with their community. And I really hope that it's seen for the value of that and not just as a luxury.
Hi, this is Stephen Schwartz saying hello from my home in Connecticut, back in the United States. I hope you enjoy this collection of my songs. And I wish us all the best in these crazy times as we continue to support the arts.
Well, thank you, Stephen Schwartz. And some beautifully candid, honest, beautiful, genuine reflections there from some important people in our industry across different areas. And we obviously recognize that our industry is very, very nuanced and incredibly broad, and lovely to hear those voices contribute to the conversation tonight. I thought I would also engage the services of a very, very good and special mate of mine, Jason Beauvaird, who is the managing director of Moving Light Productions, to rig up some beautiful lights for me tonight. I thought we'd get as spectacular as we possibly could here in eastern suburbs of Melbourne. So thank you to Jason Beauvaird. They are at Moving Light Productions, the leader in lighting design and production in commercial and independent theatre, and they are proud to be very, very beautifully and kindly supporting the arts industry at this time, and they will continue to do so and to support theatre companies and shows in the future. So thank you to Moving Light Productions, and thank you to Jason Beauvaird. We have a very good friend of mine up next, the beautiful Johanna Allen. Jojo.
Hi, can you hear me?
We can. How are you, lovely?
Can you see the amazing Vicky Jacobs at least 2 meters away from me down there?
The Vicky Jacobs, and how diligent you guys are with your social distancing. Lovely to see you both.
Our whole grand piano between us.
That's it. A grand piano.
One should always keep a grand piano between themselves and everybody else, shouldn't they?
I don't know why they haven't used that in, you know, all the promotions. It's just
they will now.
Piano's length. Yeah.
They will now. Jojo, you were doing Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
I was.
You were playing Grandma Georgina for most of the
time? I was, although for Brisbane I was actually playing Mrs. Gloop. So yeah. I'd been bumped up to the sausage lady. Yeah, the rug was pulled out from under us, as it was for so many, and it was a very surreal time.
What happened when you found out that you guys were closing? Because you had only just you were in previews in Brisbane, weren't you?
Yeah, we were about to hit previews, and we had four entirely new Charlies that had worked for 6 weeks before we got there to learn the role with our fantastic director and our resident choreographer, etc. We could see the writing on the wall, I think, but it was still very uncertain. So our company and our management made a decision to continue to perform the show four times for each of the new Charlies and invite their family. So that was pretty special. So we didn't get to open, but the boys that were playing Charlie got to perform the role in front of their family and friends. And, you know, the 11 people assembled cheered with everything they had. And it was very, very special to be part of.
Wow. Absolutely. Yeah. So moving. And I'm so sorry, because what a fantastic show. Such a bundle of fun. And it was just going so well.
It was, you know, I mean, I think in some ways we were lucky, because other people, we were in our last city. So at least we had got through most of our run. But nonetheless, we were a cast who loved each other immensely, and it was a very joyous show, and we had fantastic sales for Brisbane, and we wanted to go out with a bang together, but it didn't go that way.
Yeah, well, let's just hope that when theatres do come back, that that more and more theatres will be filled, and more audiences will enjoy the kind of magic that Charlie and the Chocolate Factory was able to bring.
Yeah, and we will come back bigger and better and stronger than ever.
We truly will. Hey, you're going to be singing one of Stephen Schwartz's most iconic, I was going to say audition pieces, but cabaret items, standalone songs, torch songs, ballads.
Oh, yeah, just a little one-act play, really, as far as his songs go, called Meadowlark.
Should we put an interval in or what?
Yeah, it goes for 45 minutes.
Okay.
No, that's not true. It goes for 23. I have the amazing skill of Vicky with me in the room, and we will perform this gorgeous song.
All yours, my friend.
Thank you. Yeah. When I was a girl, I had a favorite story of the meadowlark who lived where the rivers wide. Voice could match the angels in its glory, but she was blind. The lark was blind. An old king came and took her to his palace, where the walls were burnished bronze and gold braid. And he fed her fruit and nuts from an ivory chalice. See you.
Amazing work, Jojo. That was absolutely beautiful. Thank you so, so much for performing that. Did not feel like 23 minutes, that's for sure. We got Ryan Gonzalez next, who starred in Jersey Boys and Kinky Boots and In the Heights at the Hayes Theatre, and was about to begin rehearsals for Merrily, We Roll Along. Hello, Ryan Gonzalez.
Hey, can you hear me?
We totally can. I love your hair.
Thanks. I match your room.
You absolutely do. You would like disappear if you were in my room, vanish completely. Wow, I love. Is this an ISO thing going on?
I was blonde for 3 weeks, and then I have such thick hair, and it grows so fast. Then I got another haircut, and then all the blonde was gone. So now it's this.
I love it, and I can't wait to see what next week it'll be. So you were about to do Merrily, We Roll Along.
Yeah.
And I mean, we love the Hayes, and you love the Hayes because you're going back there.
Yeah, I've done lots of the Hayes, and I love the Hayes, and it feels weird that even though things are shut down, that we can't have 100 people in the space. That also feels weird because that space feels tiny to me.
Yeah. Look, it's a huge loss for independent theatre companies as well, isn't it? It's not just the big shows. It's absolutely the small shows, and the Hayes Theatre has done so much for the landscape of Australian theatre.
Yeah, Australian theatres, and I think up-and-coming performers and new producers and people that want to get into stage managing and stuff like that. It's just a platform for people to elevate what they already have and bring it to a more professional level. So I'm always here for the Hayes, and I love it.
And you've been doing amazing stuff in your whole career. And I really hope whatever happens that we do get to see Merrily, We Roll Along at some point, because you will be absolutely stunning in that show.
Yeah, that's true. I hope so.
Now you're going to sing one of my favorite Stephen Schwartz songs. I'm going to send it over to you to introduce yourself.
Amazing. I'm going to sing Corner of the Sky, which is in almost every male's rep book. So here we go. Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me your reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats spit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow? Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. Oh, I got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Yeah. Every man has his daydreams. Every man has his goals. People like the way dreams have ups to get to their souls. Rain comes after thunder, winter comes after fall. Why do I feel I'm not after anything at all? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Oh, eagles belong where they can fly. Oh, I got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. The sky. The sky.
That was a sick arrangement, Ryan. That was Daniel Edmonds, wasn't it, that one?
Daniel Edmonds. He's a genius.
He so is. Dude, you're a legend. Thank you so much for that. That's so cool. Well done.
Thank you.
See you soon. Well, if you would like to continue to financially support the artists who are performing tonight, of course, the GoFundMe URL is down the bottom there, gofundme.com/LUOTA, Lights Up on the Arts. Please do help out if you possibly can by buying a ticket to the show tonight. Of course, we are very, very happy to perform for you, whether it's 1 cent or more than 1 cent or much more than 1 cent. Of course, the money will be shared very equally, completely equally between all performers and our crew tonight. So thank you so much for your continued support of our artists. We have the incredible Sarah Murr now, who is one of my absolute favorites. She's a gorgeous human being and a wonderful singer. Hello, Sarah.
Hi, y'all.
Oh, I'm good. Look at you. You're in your bathroom.
Welcome to my bathroom in Townsville.
It's the best Townsville bathroom I've ever seen.
That's what I was thinking.
Obviously, because the acoustics, right? Not just because it's like you've locked yourself in for the whole of ISO.
Yeah, I'm locked in here. I'm stuck.
Okay, we'll send help.
Please.
You are not alone. Hey, you were performing in Shrek as well, weren't you?
Yep.
Shut you down. Yeah. Such a bummer, hey?
Yeah, it was a shame. I hadn't had a job for a while and I finally booked one and the cast was, we had so much fun and then it was over a weekend, we were shut. We were done.
It just happened so suddenly, didn't it?
It was bizarre. It was literally on a Friday, was the first sort of speech from ScoMo saying, maybe 500's the limit. And then we did our last show. Collectively, we sort of knew it was our last show, but we didn't have like a, you know, a definite, like, this is the last one. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it was weird. It just happened,
didn't it?
Yeah.
It did. I know. It's tough. And look, it was such a fun show, and I'm so glad that some people got to see it. I would have loved more and more to have seen it because it really was just hysterically funny, and you were fantastic in it.
Thank you. It was lots of fun.
Now, you are going to be singing a very, very special song for us tonight because it is from the brand new Prince of Egypt musical.
Yeah, no pressure.
Zero pressure, but Mr. Schwartz will be watching. Okay. But don't worry. No, it's normally sung by a male voice, so I'm so excited to hear your take on this. I'm going to send it straight over to you, mate. Go for it.
Thank you. So I just have to say thank you to my good friend Dominic Woodhead, who has not only recorded the backing for me, but also transposed. Thank you.
Legend.
Let's give it a go, hey? Footprints on the sand, ripples on the river, wispy drifting clouds that blow across the desert sky. One day we are here, and the next we vanish, vanish in the blink of an eye beside.
Murr, that was absolutely stunning, mate. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What a voice. What a voice. Even in a Townsville bathroom, you sound amazing. Thank you. So you might be able to obviously tell that a lot of us have been performing for quite a while. In fact, so many of us got our start performing in school musicals. We all remember the thrill of opening night nerves and the sound of audience applause. And without those formative experiences, we might not have discovered our path into this industry. It's an environment where students are able to find their voice and develop their craft. While schools are closed and students are enjoying the benefit of their incredible teachers via remote learning, so many schools have been faced with this dilemma of what can be done to keep their school productions alive so students don't miss out on this experience. Sadly, many, many schools have just not been able to make it work. We reached out to Carey Baptist Grammar School and we asked their director, Tim Schwert, and students who were due to perform in their school musical, Chicago, how their school musical experience was impacted. So take a look at this.
And this year we had to cancel our production of Chicago, the big main stage musical for the year. And that means that 47 performers plus students in the band, in the crew, working under the stage in hair and makeup and front of house, all missed out on doing something together, collectively, connectedly. And I guess that really is just a small version of what's happening around the world in performing arts.
What I miss most about the musical is the feeling of accomplishment at the end of a show and at the end of the show season, looking back and reflecting on all the relationships that have been developed and everything that we've overcome together, and not being able to share that feeling with the rest of the cast.
The arts are definitely something which I could not live without, because I just love engaging in all these creative activities. They really just, they move people more than anything else, and I think that's such an important thing. I really enjoyed the chance to be in Chicago, and although all this work didn't culminate in anything in the larger picture, it in another way, in a way that's indirect, it really did.
What I miss most about Carey Musical is definitely the culture. The culture among Carey Performing Arts is so, so strong, and it really does help you get through it all.
The cancellation of Chicago is pretty disappointing, but it's also an indicator of how much we actually appreciate the arts and theatre and those sorts of programs. The things I sort of appreciated the most about Chicago was the fact that as a community, there's lots of expressive people with passions for just generally a lot of really talented people.
It's a tough time, but all I keep thinking about is the fact that sometime in the future, this will be over and we can move on. So until then, I just hope that everyone hangs tight, keeps connected, keeps talking to each other, and we keep our eyes above the horizon looking to the future.
Thank you to Carey Baptist Grammar School and to Tim Schwert for those insights into your production. Look, thank you to all the schools that are desperately trying to find a way for the arts to be celebrated, for those that are scrambling to make it work, for the teaching staff who have just poured so much time and energy and passion into productions that will have to be cancelled if they haven't been already. And to the students, we here at Lights Up on the Arts just want to say to you that we see you. Our heart is breaking for you because it is really sad and it sucks. We understand how much the school production means to you. It might feel like it's the end of... Sorry. It might feel like it's the end of opportunities right now for you, but I guarantee you it's not. There is light at the end of the tunnel. There are people out there who love theatre as much as you, and you will find your tribe, and it's much bigger than a school production. There is community theatre. There are training programs and performing arts schools everywhere. And I'm confident that you will find your tribe. So please hang in there, guys. I know it sucks. And we are all thinking of you. Oh, so let's move on. Someone who knows a lot, I think, about finding hope in darkness is the cast of Come From Away. And we have Doug Hansell here tonight. Doug, g'day, mate. Welcome. I think we got you there, Doug. I hope we do. Doug is, of course, one of the incredible ensemble members from the award-winning production of Come From Away. Doug, do you want to give us a shout-out, mate? I want to know if you're there. And if not, we'll just have to hold on for a second and try and find you. I want to skip back for 1 second because while Sarah Murr was performing, I want to do a big shout-out to those of you who threw in some incredible puns on her name, and I think this is probably some sort of setting up of what her future career involves. Les Miserables, or maybe even The Little Mermaid, as two of the standouts there. So thank you guys for that. We're actually going to put a pause on Doug. I reckon we'll get back to him in a moment. We've got some technical difficulties. So I want to jump now over to one of my very long-standing and very dear friends, Michelle Brasier. Do we have Michelle Brasier in the house this evening?
My little James.
Oh, mate. Hello.
Oh, no, I'm so embarrassed. I forgot this was on.
You look like...
No, I've just worn my pajamas under this. I'm so embarrassed.
No, it's so awful, isn't it? Is that a... I see some stage lights in the background.
Oh, they're just my sleep lights. I'm so embarrassed.
Oh, mate. So
oh, no.
Yeah. How's ISO going for you?
It's fine. I put on all of the makeup that I haven't been wearing in isolation just on tonight. So in case it, because it's going to expire. So
yeah,
I've really
it's
committed to
it
that.
It looks pretty.
Tonight.
You've laid it on thick.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, that's
a compliment.
It was definitely a compliment.
Thank you.
You were doing you were set to do a show for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival.
I was set to do several shows for the Melbourne Comedy Festival and the Sydney Comedy Festival and the Brisbane and Perth Comedy Festivals. All but one of them was cancelled. We got to do Brisbane, but the rest were all canned in the butt.
And you won the Moosehead Award for Most Promising Show. So everyone was looking forward to seeing what you were going to do.
Yeah, it was sad. I had attention, which I love. And then it went away, James. But it was nice. I got a grant out of it. And then I got to pay my director, the beautiful Gillian Cosgrove. Shout out for Gillian Cosgrove.
Yeah.
And my beautiful musician and life partner, Tim Lancaster. So they got paid, just not me.
Just not you.
But that's okay. I'll be okay. I'm a big, strong girl.
You're a big, strong girl, and you look amazing tonight. I love your, you said sleepwear.
Yeah.
Thank it looks you. Amazing. Hey, you were in a Stephen Schwartz show.
I was, the only musical I ever did, because I realised I can't sit still and do what I'm told. But yes, I did Children of Eden when I was just a wee thing. I think I was maybe 21. And yeah, I played Aisha.
It is one of my favorite musicals of all time. I just adore it. I remember the production so vividly. I know Schwartz came out to see it. You got to meet him.
Yes, he came and talked to us. He came and sat in the room and said, scrap this, change this. And we were like, it's very exciting.
Yeah, no. And he loved the show, I remember.
Oh, well, I hope so. I can't remember. I just remember staring at him being like, Schwartz. So it's, you know, that's all I've got.
And you're singing the title role from Children of Eden tonight?
Yes, I'm singing Children of Eden from Children of Eden. Thank you so much.
And you're accompanied by Shannon Whitelock.
Yes, I've got him here tonight. This is Shannon Whitelock. I'll just...
That's you shrunk him down and flattened him.
Yes, that's the way he wanted to be remembered. So, yes. All right. Bless his heart.
Do your thing. Do your thing.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, hang on. I'll press play. Wasn't I good when nobody knew that it was going to be me next because it was meant to be someone else? And then just what a pro. Goodness gracious.
You're such a pro.
Thank you. Oh, false start. Let's try that again. Hang on. It's musicals. Focus. Like this brief day, my light is nearly gone. But through the night, my children, you will go on. Second chances, children of Eden, where have we left you? Born to uncertainty, destined for pain, sins of your parents. And test you. This your inheritance, fire and rain. Children of Eden, try not to blame us. We were just human to err upon. Children of Eden.
Michelle Brasier. Yes. Woo. Stunning work, mate. That was absolutely gorgeous. Thank you so much.
You're gorgeous, James.
You're gorgeous. Mwah. We've got Lucy Maunder next. So this lineup is just like bam, 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 one after the other. Incredible, amazing performers. Lucy Maunder, who got a big break in the world premiere of Dr. Zhivago. She was Rizzo in Greece. She was in Into the Woods. She was in Beautiful, the Carole King story. She was Miss Honey in Matilda. And how wonderful she was in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory as the incredible, delightful Mrs. Bucket. Hello, Lucy Maunder.
Hi. How are you, Jay?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Well, thank you. Very well.
It's been an amazing night so far, hey?
Oh, it's been incredible. I just love Stephen Schwartz. I love his music. I love the tunes. I love how moving it all is. And yeah, everybody's just so amazing. And it just is heartwarming that this is happening, but also really sad because they should all be on a stage.
They should. And look, right now we have such a big stage, so we're just able to, you know, to do all we can right now and just, yes, we're in our living rooms, but the beautiful thing is that all of us together are in our living rooms.
Exactly, exactly. And I'm thrilled to be here. Thank you for having me.
And you were so great in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. I absolutely loved your performance.
Oh, thank you.
It was very real, very tender.
A great role, even though I was sort of, I think I had about 12 minutes of stage time. I didn't come on at all in the second act, so... it was a long time from the end of Act One to coming on to Bow, but there were some really lovely moments in Act One and beautiful songs, and yeah, it was a joy. And as Jojo said before, it was a gorgeous company of people, and we really were harmonious and just adored each other. And it was sad to say goodbye, but then yeah, we were lucky enough to get 16 months out of it, so.
Which is not a bad run, is it?
Yeah, exactly.
Absolutely. You must have got up to some wild antics backstage with all of that downtime in Act Two.
Yeah, I mean, I think I did my tax. I did a whole lot of lots of life admin because I have a 3-year-old as well. So that was kind of my hour of the day to catch up on stuff that I wasn't able to do.
Yes. Is she in bed now?
No, she's actually watching Moana for a change. The next room. So if she runs in during the song, I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize. Use it. You know, make her a co-star.
Exactly.
And she's gorgeous too. Hey, you're going to sing for us?
Yes, I'm going to sing a song from a lesser-known musical called Wicked. And this is probably one of the slowest and stillest parts of the show. It's called I'm Not That Girl, and I'm lucky enough to have a backing track provided by the incredible Hayden Baltrop. So he was in Sydney and did this for me, so I thank you, Hayden.
Beautiful. All right, go for it, Lucy. We're looking forward to it.
Oh, God. I hope this works.
I wasn't born for the roses.
It may be one of the slow, intimate moments of Wicked, but Lucy, that was absolutely gorgeous, performing right into our cameras. Well done.
Thanks for having me.
Well, I don't want to get you off the hook yet, because there have been so many requests for you to bring Edie out as your co-star. They're like, get that girl away from Moana and bring her. So good. Oh my gosh. This is happening, people. I really hope she's dressed up as Galinda. And I'm ready for you guys to maybe sing some For Good. I'm ready for that. Even like, just put her out there alone and she can sing popular. Like that. I'm fine with that too. Honestly, I am. Guys, sorry we haven't been able to bring Doug yet, but we are aiming to bring him back in just a moment. I promise you that will happen. As one of our, as our representative from Come From Away, one of two representatives from Come From Away tonight. Edie, hello. Oh, what a big, beautiful wave that was. How are you, Edie? Oh, that's good. What have you been watching? Have you been watching TV?
Moana.
Oh, well, that's good. That's not a bad one to watch, hey. Were you watching MasterChef as well? Good, because I don't want you to spoil it. I'm going to watch it later on.
I was watching something enthralling her on Channel 7 today, and I went to change it to ABC Kids, and she said, hey, I'm watching that. And then I went back to Channel 7. It was a show called Murder Pact, so that's good.
Hmm. I mean, look, I was thinking it was going to be ScoMo's announcement. So,
no.
The Daniel Andrews, maybe.
Exactly.
Well, Edie, it's so nice to have you come and visit us. Thank you for coming to say hi to us. Good night. You are beautiful. Lucy, thank you so much. And have a wonderful rest of your night. Thank you. Now, who are we going to go to next? I think we'll see. We'll put Dougie on the back burner. I reckon it might be time for us to show a quick video of some of the stuff that our performers and artists are getting up to when they're at home with too much time on their hands and no theatre to perform in, finding new ways to creatively express themselves. So check out this video that came out a few weeks ago from Steph Jones and Aaron Zindos, their take on the a cover of 1, 2, 3, 4 with a political message about the arts.
One, two, three, four, folks together, it's on the floor. 5, 6, 7, 8, all of us commiserate. All you MPs obsessed with the law left us with no.
And that was Steph Jones and Aaron Zindos with a fantastic message, political message coming through. Look, it just sort of shows some of the fantastic things that people are doing during this time. I think they're called pandemic pivots, is what sort of people have, the phrase people have coined for the way they are negotiating lockdown and being in isolation. This just shows some of the creativity coming out, but gosh, there's so much out there right now. Everything from the Isolate Late Show, the Social Dis Dance Project, Remotely Funny. I know there's podcasts and there's dance projects, the Isola Project, the Sunday Picture Club, which is formerly known as the Apocalypse Portraits. There really is so much stuff that is going on right now, and we would encourage you get out there and see what people are doing, what people are creating, and share it with other people, and make us laugh, bring us some joy. Now I wonder, how are we going? Are we at a position yet to bring Dougie in? Have we got Doug? I don't know if we have Doug yet. We're desperately hoping we got Doug. Do we have Doug? You might also notice that I have changed my clothes. I've pulled a Carols by Candlelight host sort of situation. I think that's because I'm just sort of cycling through all the outfits I was going to be wearing for the various opening night parties. I think now we have an incredibly special guest. We have our youngest, well, I was going to say youngest performer, but we just had Edie. So our second youngest performer, he was one of the Billy Elliots. In Billy Elliot, we have got Jamie Rogers. Yeah. Hey, Jamie.
Hi.
Dude, you look amazing.
Thank you.
Tell me about this. Have you been wearing it nonstop for the last 6 weeks?
It's been getting quite cold in Canberra, so I've been needing something to keep me warm, so I've been wearing this quite a lot.
That looks like it will definitely keep you warm.
Yes.
How is your remote learning going?
It's pretty good. Not used to it, but yeah. I'm getting used to it now.
I'll tell you what, between you guys doing your remote learning and the teachers doing their remote teaching, you are all doing an incredible job. It really is a different world, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is.
And Billy Elliot, that was a different world too, because that was the first show that you ever have done, your first big pro gig.
Yep.
Congratulations, mate.
Thank you very much.
And what was it like going into the first audition, huh?
Well, when I started, I was mainly going there for the experience, just to see what an audition was like, and then callbacked after callback, and then I got the role.
You did. So you really got the full experience then, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. What was it like doing your final performance of Billy Elliot? Because obviously it was a big surprise.
Yeah. So I did my final performance, and then they sort of like gave us a little like warning that the show might close, and then they said that, so I performed, and then the next day they said this may be the last show, and then after the show they said there's going to be no more shows.
Oh, they confirmed it straight afterwards.
Yeah.
So really you were doing your last performance not really even knowing that it was your last performance.
Yeah. Wow,
that's pretty full on.
Mm.
Well, you and all the other Billies were just incredible. My hat well and truly off to all you guys.
Thank you.
Such an amazing show. And we've got Justin Smith, who played your dad, coming on the show later on.
Yep.
He was very excited to hear that you're singing and performing for us tonight. And
yes.
I want to hand over to you because I'm the boring one and you're the interesting one. So why don't you tell us what you're performing and who did the accompaniment for you?
Okay. So I'm going to be performing Extraordinary from the musical Pippin, and the backing track is played by Diana Nixon.
Amazing. All right, Jamie, all over to you, mate. Go for it.
Thank you. Patch in the roof. Picture the hay is not my idea of the perfect day. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you think about extraordinary things. That's the reason I special. It's hard to feel big. Feeding the turtle and walking the pig. It's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the moat won't stop leaking and the goat won't stop shrieking and the griffin keeps losing its air, and the west wing is rotting and our best wine is clotting, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I've got to be someone who lives all of his life in superlatives. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm different is easy to see, so why doesn't anybody know it but me? I'm extraordinary. I need to do extraordinary things. Every so often a man has a day he truly can call his. Well, here I am to seize my day, if someone will just tell me when the hell it is. Oh, give me my chance and give me my wings, and don't make me think about everyday things. They're unnecessary to someone who is very extraordinary.
Jamie Rogers, yes! Oh my gosh, I'm puffed out just watching you, my friend. You are amazing.
Thank you.
So good, and you've done all your isolation fitness for the day, and you've done my part for me as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
I love that tap dancing floor. I want one. If you can send it to Melbourne, that'd be great. Okay.
Yep.
You're a legend. Thank you so much for performing for us tonight, Jamie.
Thank you.
See you, mate. Oh my gosh, these guys, they're getting younger and younger, aren't they? So yes, as you know, tonight we are looking to support artists and this is obviously so that we can celebrate live performance and acknowledge that we have an entire fleet of people from a very, very nuanced industry, and we wish to give voice to all of them and celebrate them tonight. And we all want to continue feeling the thrill of live theatre, as I said earlier. So we do want you to enjoy yourselves tonight. And a reminder that our GoFundMe address is right down the bottom there, gofundme.com/LUOTA, Lights Up on the Arts. And if you'd like to help out tonight by buying a ticket, you can absolutely do that. Just head onto that page there, and all monies that we receive tonight will be evenly distributed amongst our performers and also those off stage as well who are helping us out in various backstage capacities. So this is our way of making sure that live performance does not get forgotten, and of course you are helping out, helping us pay our bills and support our families and all those sorts of things that to be quite frank, we're going to be struggling to do over who knows how many months for the foreseeable future as more and more shows continue to be closed down. I think it was said today by Opera Australia that now over 570 shows, as in theatrical productions, have closed for 2020 so far, which is a staggering amount when you think about the ushers and the production teams, the designers, the collaborators, the technicians, the crew, the performers, the theatre managers, and so on. It really is so, so, so very many, many people. So anything you can do tonight to help us would be very much appreciated. And we will share all of our monies equally, as I said, amongst our company. We now have Lyndon Watts here, who was due to open a chorus line with Darlinghurst. G'day, Lyndon.
Hello, hello. How you doing?
I'm doing good, man. How are you?
I'm good.
So good to see you. And your ISO hair, I'm seeing it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm digging it.
You can see what stage of crisis the person is at by what colour their hair is.
And what stage is pink?
It's getting drastic.
Okay, like we're talking like 7 out of 10?
Yeah, I like that number. 7 out of 10 works for me.
It's a healthy 7. All right, let me know when it progresses what's beyond pink, because there's a lot of pink right now and I'm scared of what the next level could be, but who knows, we'll wait and see. So you were doing Chorus Line.
I was, yes.
And
see the company up in Sydney.
Yeah, and when did you guys sort of find out that the show was closing?
We had a pretty strong feeling, as I think most people do, what was coming, what sort of happened over a weekend, as we've heard tonight. We had 4 previews of the show, so we were in really good shape and looking forward to opening night. And the morning of opening night, we were sort of called into the theatre by our beautiful producers and creatives and sort of given the news that the day of opening night, we were not going to be able to open, unfortunately. Devastating.
Wow. On the day of opening night. That's big. And the Chorus Line is such a meaningful show to so many people. It's about artists. In work and out of work, trying to gain work, trying to win work.
Stay in employment, yeah. It was very close to home. Those last few performances we got to do were incredibly special and incredibly real and raw. And
because you guys got to do some previews.
Yeah.
So you had audiences, you got to sort of speak that text.
From those audiences, and hopefully we get back to that, because the show is very special. And
yeah, wow. And Darlinghurst is such an important theatre company as well.
Yes, incredible. They're just beautiful people. They're really beautiful people who are incredible at what they do, and they've been doing it for years. So working for them was like Italian chef kisses. Loved it.
Yeah. Well, I'm really hoping for all the best for you moving forwards, and I really hope we get to see a Chorus Line come back at some point. I really hope so.
Me too. Fingers crossed.
Yeah. Now, what are you going to sing for us?
I'm doing Lost in the Wilderness from Children of Eden.
Awesome, mate. Awesome. Well, I know you're going to kill it. Have fun.
Thanks, mate.
And I love your backdrop too.
Thank you very much. I never made this world. I didn't even lose it, and I know no one said it was fair. But they had the garden once, they had the chance to choose it, and they gave it away, including my share. And now we're lost in the wilderness, lost, crying in the wilderness. And if anyone's watching, it seems they couldn't care less. We're lost in the wilderness. You follow all the rules, and you swallow all the stories, and every night you wish on a star, hoping your day will come, trusting in allegories, and every morning, boy, look where you are. Lost in the wilderness, lost, slowly dying in the wilderness, with no chance of living, boy, till you confess you're lost in the wilderness. Don't you ever watch the eagle fly to the sun and wonder how he got to feel so free? If you ever have, you know your journey's begun. Hey, what have you got to lose, boy, when already we are lost in the wilderness? And where we are headed, boy, I couldn't even guess, but off we go without a warning, running as we hit the ground, where our future lies a morning, where our hearts lie out, we bow till the bright and distant morning. We may stop, look around, and there in the wilderness, finally will be. Fine.
That was awesome, Lyndon. Champion effort, mate.
Thank you, buddy.
Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your night. Enjoy ISO.
Thank you so much.
Let me know what happens next with the hair. I'm sure it'll be like PVA glue or sawdust or both, something.
I'll keep you in the loop.
Do, please do. All right, I want to show you guys a video now. It's a really important message from Will Centurion. So take a look at this really important message from him.
How did the impacts of the COVID-19 crisis affect you? How long before it was no longer a story? At what point did you realize it was happening around you? In a matter of weeks, our industry was unrecognizable. Shows were closed, tours were suspended, and the doors to live performance were shut. We never imagined that a virus would be the thing that would disconnect us from our creativity. Many of us are still managing our grief because we have all lost something important to us. The opportunity to be seen, the opportunity to be heard, and the chance to make a difference. You are not alone. We are all going through this together, and each of us is trying to find a way to give this pain some purpose. So what can we as a community do? Acknowledge that this is a temporary challenge and that the journey forward will be an emotional one. Recognize that you have the capacity to get through this, because if there's one thing that your creative journey has taught you, it's that you are resilient. Initiate even the smallest of actions to repair, because there is greatness in all of your little wins. Seek out the support of others, because no matter how dark it gets, someone will always hold a torch for you. Engage again in your greatest strength, creativity, because that is a power that no one can take away from us. Our journey may be interrupted. We may not have all the answers yet, but hold on strong to hope, because what comes next is an explosion of creativity that will rewrite our story. Let's work together and bring the lights up on the arts.
And that was a really important message there from Will Centurion. Thank you so much, mate. And it really is an important time right now because we're in such a precarious time. And, you know, we're so prone to not protecting our mental health. So please do speak up and do reach out. Okay, I think next we have got Andy Cook and Glenn Hill. Have you got your guys there?
Can you hear us?
We can absolutely hear you. How are you?
We're good. Thank you for having us. And hi, everybody at home watching in your living rooms. Mushy mushy.
I'm just having such a blast tonight. It's so good just seeing all these amazing performers in the one space.
I'm loving seeing everybody's lounge rooms and what they've done with the decorating.
We love interior design.
Oh, good. You're getting some good notes.
Yeah, we're taking notes of cushions and like colors on the wall.
Yeah, awesome. Good. Yeah, chrysanthemum on the wall. Check. Superfluous cushions. John O'Hara. Check.
Everybody. It's awesome. It's awesome.
Yeah, that's it. So you guys are obviously in ISO together, which is amazing.
We are. We're here in our house in Victoria in Brunswick West, and we've got our two little doggies here with us as well. So I guess compared to some other people, we've got it pretty good in this scenario, but you know, it's not ideal for anybody, I don't think, at the moment. So
probably good for the dogs. Yeah. They're probably loving it.
They would. I think dogs planned this whole thing, to be honest. I think they're responsible.
Especially ours.
I know so many people who have gone and bought pets in the last few weeks, and these pets are not going to know what hit them when we all go back to normal and suddenly we just leave them all day long.
Separation anxiety. Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be a wild time when we finally come out of this.
Maybe that can be my next career choice, as a dog therapist or something. Maybe that'll be a big business.
People are going to need them, you know, get creative. That's what this is about. Try to, you know, carve your way through, do what you can. And yep, dog therapy, way to go.
That's right.
So you guys met on show, didn't you? You were in, was it Matilda?
We met on Matilda.
Yeah, that's right.
Amazing. And you guys have obviously gone and done various projects since then. Andy, you did Beautiful, and I know you're in Chicago. And Glenn, you were doing Jersey. You did Jersey Boys, and
I was booked to do the upcoming tour of Secret Garden with the master that is Anthony Warlow. So sadly, we fell victim to the current situation as well. So unfortunately, that show is no longer going ahead.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. So sorry to hear that. What a beautiful show. And you guys with Lyndon, we're all in a chorus line together.
We were in Lycra, correct? Yes.
Beautiful. Well, I mean, I'm sorry you didn't think wisely enough to wear your Lycra tonight, but...
You just can't see us from the waist down.
Yeah, it's
so
a party.
That's
yeah.
good. We're good.
Okay, well, I know that you guys are going to have to back away when you start singing if there's any high notes coming up. So we'll be looking out for the Lycra then. What are you singing for us?
We are going to do a song from Godspell, which was written back in the 70s, but we're kind of going to do a little bit more of a gospel version of the track. So it's called Save the People. So we hope you enjoy.
And Daniel Edmonds is playing for us. And I just want to say thank you. That man is supplying backings for our entire industry right now. We love you. You're amazing. So thank you.
Awesome, boys. We love your work. Go for it.
When wilt thou save the people? Oh God of mercy, when the people, Lord, the people, not thrones and crowns, but men, flowers of thy heart, oh God, are they? Let them not pass like weeds away. The heritage, a sunless day.
Yes, you boys. I mean, there was no Lycra, but there were a lot of good notes in that.
Thanks,
that's
guys.
Amazing.
Thank you.
I want to hear that at the next Carols by Candlelight.
Hey, listen, you organize it, we'll be there without
bells on.
I just hope it's open by then.
Yes, cross fingers for Christmas.
You know it. Hey, guys, thank you so much for performing tonight. That was just the best. That was so good.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for doing this.
Cheers.
Mwah.
Okay. Bye.
Awesome, boys. See ya. Guys, this is just such a good night. I'm loving the spirit of the night. There's so much hope and so much joy in all of this. We've got some huge performances coming up. We've got another song from Wicked. We've got Children of Eden. And we've got the beautiful Clean Morgan coming up. We have Joe Kosky from Kinky Boots and School of Rock coming up. And we have some final performances that you have to see to believe them. They are incredible. I reckon we might try our luck with Doug Hansell from Come From Away. Come on, Doug. Dude.
Hello. It looks like my internet connection has been the star of the night. Far out. Stress. Anything that can go wrong will go wrong.
You know what? Nothing can go wrong when you've got that perfectly placed tree behind your head. Do not move.
Yes.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, that's it.
It's like the Statue of Liberty, yeah?
People are screaming in that moment. It looks amazing. And that microphone. What?
That's a tip off from Ben Mingay. Thank you, Ben. Unfortunately, I don't have the set that Ben has, but...
Yeah, disappointed you couldn't get that piano up on the truck. I was just, we were talking before about, we were sort of on a bit of a thread about hope and finding hope in darkness and Come From Away really just epitomized that, because it was such a dark time of world history, and Come From Away really celebrates the humanity and the hope and the goodness that came out of that dark time.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think that once this is all over, lots of people just want to go back to the theatre for that sense of normality, but I think there's a special resonance with Come From Away, and I think out of crisis it shows what human beings can do, what they're capable of, and the goodness that's inherent in all of us. And hopefully that will mean that once we get back up and running, and we will get back up and running, we're very fortunate. We were meant to be in China right now, and that got cancelled in January, and then we're meant to be opening in August in Sydney. So we're just waiting to see what comes of that, but we will be back for sure.
I mean, they talked about a scheduled return to Melbourne for 2021, didn't they?
Absolutely, yeah.
Which is incredible, because you guys smashed records at the Comedy Theatre, gosh, I know so many people who saw that show not just once, but they turned around as soon as they walked out of the theatre, bought themselves another ticket, they went multiple times. What a powerful show.
The record was about 47. We know of a guy that saw it 47 times.
Wow. So that's, wow. Yeah. And I know you guys have that toilet paper line in the show, which is scripted.
I know. It was really frustrating, because that just got, as the pandemic sort of built up, that laugh got bigger and bigger and bigger. And it sort of felt like, it felt a bit cheap. We're like, no, we haven't added that line.
People thought that you threw it in.
Exactly, yeah. Which would have
been. So, like, the thing about we need to buy more toilet paper.
Exactly, yeah.
Congratulations, mate. Your performance, but every single actor's performance was so embodied and so truthful. And, hats off to all of you.
Thank you, mate. That's what I like about the show. Like, there's no one person that sort of carries it. All 12 of us carry it together. And it's real, true ensemble work, which is really delightful.
It really is. And look, I want you to sing for us, because we've got you on. We've got connectivity. Let's use you while we've got you, mate.
I know, right. This is Dreamscape from Reluctant Pilgrim. I am dreaming of a riverbank, mists enshroud the farther shore. I am standing in a wooden boat, in my hands a golden oar. Will I row against the current, or let myself be carried out to sea, where I reach land at last is up to the river, but the journey's up to me. Time to sail, reluctant pilgrim. My fear is all I've got to lose. Life is nothing but a dreamscape, and the dream is mine. Open any one of them, step on through and change my life. Sometimes I pause there on the threshold, afraid to leave my bright familiar hall. Sometimes I spend my days running by so quickly, I don't see the door. Nothing
forest glade, needles of pine are in my hair. I see pathways through the underbrush, leading to I don't know where. I hear strange noises in the thickets, and I know some trails may not lead where they seem. Pain may await me, but I know if I stay here, I'll sleep right through my dream. Time to sail, reluctant pilgrim. My fear is all I've got to lose. Life is nothing, nothing but a dreamscape, and the dream.
And it looks like we've got Andrew Kroenert here. Okay.
You're right, man. How you doing?
Good, mate. Just, you know what? Jump in. Sing us a song. Go for it. We'll talk afterwards.
All right. No worries. I'm in love. I'm in love again. I'm in love. I'm in love. And isn't it a crime? Isn't it a crying shame that the love of my life should happen to be another man's wife? But I finally found the one true love of my life. I see her Monday afternoon. She's buying eggs, I'm buying cheese, and I decide it's none too soon to try my famous old technique I call the tease. So I brush up against her skin and pat her like she was a child, and then I flash my secret grin and give my head the little toss that drives them wild. She acts as though she doesn't even know I'm there, and in an instant that the eggs are in her clutch, she just ignores my touch. She likes me very much, and I'm singing, oh, proud lady. And you and I both know someday you will be mine. Then we'll go to a place where the grass is cool and shady. With a smile on your face, you'll come into my arms, and love will flow like wine. Next time I go to get the bread, I know exactly what to wear. My pants are tight, my shirt is red, and open just enough to show a little hair. Yeah. And when the bag is full and warm, the way I lift it, she can tell that any action I perform, I do it strong, I do it slow, I do it well. She asks me, can I hurry up? And when I wink, she gives a smile, and in a voice as sweet as wine, she tells me I'm a swine.
She's obviously in my line, and I'm singing, oh, proud lady, and you and I both know someday you will be mine, and we'll go to a place where the grass is cool and shady. With a smile on your face, you'll come into my arms, and love will flow like wine. I'm in love again. I'm in love, and isn't it a crime? Isn't it a crying shame that the love of my life should happen to be another man's wife? Well, I'm sorry for the guy, but there's nothing I won't try. When I finally have the one true love of my life.
Okay, oofty doofty.
Doofty
doofty. I reckon we had about 400 people post that during your song just then on our Facebook Live. And I was hoping to be the first, but alas. How you doing, bro?
Yeah, good, man. What's shaking?
Oh, mate, that was a stunning arrangement. That was just
amazing. I mean, you asked for a laid-back version, and when I listened to the song, I was like, what the hell?
You're right.
That, but yeah,
I want something chilled with rum, bum, 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 bum. I mean, gosh, like that's Baker's Wife for 2020. Well, I don't know, is any show for 2020? How's ISO treating you?
Yeah, pretty good, man. I'm just like doing the same as everyone, just getting by, teaching, singing. I'm actually cleaning trains 3 days a week, which is just a swell time, but you got to do what you got to do, you know.
And you are rocking a sick ISO beard. That's amazing.
Yeah, thanks, man. I actually went to the barbers and they trimmed it up, so I can't really claim all of it. I just grew it and they styled it.
Well, you grow it, you know. Farmers claim the credit too when they grow veggies. Why can't you claim
that? that's a stretch at best, Cutler, but we'll go for it.
You'll go with it. Look, I've always been jealous of your hair all through School of Rock, and you're putting me to shame once again. I miss being married to you.
Yeah, me too. And I miss James and I had this great ongoing backstory called Sushi Saga, and I miss that heaps, man.
We added to that story night after night for 400 performances. We got to what, season 9, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
What will happen to Mr. Spencer Williams lying in a coma somewhere? Unless the show comes back. But yeah. Hey bro, thank you so much for singing for us tonight. That was just glorious.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me, man. Appreciate it.
Ta, all the best, bro.
See you, mate.
We have Loren Hunter next. Now, Loren Hunter is just incredible. She's performing Defying Gravity, accompanied by Stephen Kramer. She was Liza Minnelli in Boy from Oz, a production company. She was in American Psycho, Evie May, both at the Hayes. And yeah, Wicked with Free Reign, which was directed by Sean Rennie. Hello, Loren Hunter.
Hello, James.
I have been so looking forward to hearing your take on Defying Gravity all night.
Thank you. I'm very nervous.
There's no reason to be. You've sung many times before. Even today, you've sung
weird.
Many times.
I wonder if anybody else thinks that it feels that it gets easier or if it just gets harder.
We're in uncharted waters right now, aren't we? Singing in front of a laptop in our bedrooms and bathrooms.
But this is the bathroom I did grow up singing in, you know.
Oh, well, then you're a natural. This is just exactly the same as all those other times. Hey, you were playing Jane Seymour in Six.
I was, yes.
James, what an incredible experience, hey?
I know, it was just incredible. I miss it.
We are wishing you all the very best, because I really want that show to come back. I want a chance to see it, because I didn't get to see it. So many people want to see that show. You're in Brisbane right now.
I am, my home.
How good's that? A bit of, you know, forced downtime.
Yes. I'm very lucky, actually, to have ended up here, I have to say. So I count my lucky stars.
Yes. Spending some time, what, doing?
With family.
Yeah.
Just, you know, wine time by the pool, you know?
Yeah, good. Mindfulness.
Yes.
That's the way. Well, I know you performed Elphaba, so let's hear it. Let's hear some.
Okay, I've got to do a bit of sharing of audio, so just bear with me, everyone.
We are bearing. It is worth waiting for your rendition of Defying Gravity. Absolutely.
Okay. Here we go, everyone.
I will buy all of your albums. Hey, family! That is my favorite thing. I'm hoping my mum does that to me at some point tonight. She's sitting right here. Lauren, that was amazing, mate.
Thanks, mate. That was quite hard, but that's okay.
You know what? Everyone is doing what they can right now, and you know, you are doing it. You are doing it in style. Thank you so much for tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Wow, you're a legend.
All the love to everyone.
Gorgeous. Thank you so much, Lauren. Look, you know, if you jump onto the website, ilostmygig.net.au, you will find out that there has been, to date, a recorded income loss of over $340 million in cancelled events and postponed events in Australia and New Zealand. That is a huge impact in lots of different kinds of jobs across events, performers, production, crew, hospo workers, managers, booking agents, wardrobe departments, designers, technicians, ushers. There are so many people who are really really needing a voice right now and needing to be seen. And I'm just so happy that we have people tonight who are shining a light on all of that and reminding us that the arts are strong. They will come back bigger and stronger than ever, and it will take a lot of time. I just want to remind you again of the GoFundMe.com/LUOTA. I have to make sure I get that right. Lights up on the arts. Please, anything that you would like to pay, if you'd like to help pay and buy a ticket tonight, and you do have the best seat in the house, so you know, don't be afraid to pay premium seats. But we do thank you so much. We're really, really indebted to you and very appreciative of your generosity this evening. Yes, I think it's time for us to show another video now, featuring some other non-performers who have been impacted by the arts shutdown. So let's take a look at that.
My name is Lisa Campbell, and I am a producer, casting director, and chair of Hayes Theatre Company.
Hello, actor director Luke Jocelyn here. I have worked on and off in this business for the last 15 to 20 years.
Hello, my name is Harriet Snaith, and I'm an independent producer. I've been running my production company, 1998 Productions, for 2 years.
That now, alongside being a producer, casting director, and chair of his theatre company, I now run a school.
It was only a number of weeks ago that we were treading the boards in Shrek the musical. I was engaged on that show as a resident director, and I remember the date clearly. The 23rd of March was when we had the company meeting to tell us that it was no longer going ahead. It does take an enormous hit on you mentally. I think for me it was sort of an overwhelming sense of sadness that this had happened to our industry more broadly. You know, it didn't just affect performers on stage, it affected all creatives, mechanists, flymen, ushers, bar staff, stage managers, producers themselves. It was affecting so many people, and the industry literally overnight had shut. Financially, of course, it's been extremely tough, but you know, we'll get through that. We're resourceful. I mean, I think creative people are extremely resourceful. We've had to be over the years in order to survive in between gigs.
Currently, we should be in the middle of our season of stepping out at Chapel Off Chapel. Chapel closed a week before we were meant to start rehearsals, and we of course had to postpone our show. Our industry comes with so much disappointment already, and one of the joys of being a producer is seeing the excitement that comes when you offer someone a role. Having to then take that away, it was truly devastating for me.
Buy a ticket when the world writes itself.
These great initiatives like Arts, Tasker and In Between, which are these sort of social media resources that that the industry can go to and connect with not only one another but those outside the industry. There have been many great opportunities that have been offered up through this platform, which I think is terrific. So you know, there's a shift in how we're connecting with one another, but also there's a shift in how people on the peripheral of what we do are staying connected with us and supporting us. I kind of feel like there will be this sort of national sort of psyche collective, if you like, for lack of a better term, that will want to get out and support as much as they can to prop us up once again. And it not only goes to the arts and entertainment, it also goes to the hospitality industry, etc., etc. I think there will be a real push to get back out there and support once again. In answer to that question, buy a ticket. Once it all opens up again, get out there. Don't be afraid. Buy a ticket, get involved, subscribe again, and keep our business alive.
I'm very active on social media at the moment, and digital word of mouth is an incredibly powerful tool. Please share our stories and our shows because we are not getting enough coverage in the media as is. When everyone is back up and running, I strongly urge you to support not just the commercial, but the independent shows as well.
Hi, this is Stephen Schwartz saying hello from my home in Connecticut, back in the United States. I hope you enjoy this collection of my songs, and I wish us all the best in these crazy times as we continue to support the arts.
Thank you, Stephen. And this is James Cutler wearing all the ties that I was going to be wearing for opening nights. And Josh told me to make sure I wore something special tonight, so I thought that I would do that. We're at the home stretch now. There's only a few acts left, but by jingoes, we've got Clee Morgan coming up. We have Todd McKenney coming up. We have an incredible duet that's going to bring you to tears. And right now we have Justin Smith from Billy Elliot, and he has inspired me, and I'm sure many other people in my generation. Good evening, Justin Smith.
Why, hi there, James. How are you?
I'm doing really good. How are you doing?
Yeah, good. Yeah, really good.
You look like you're in a linen cupboard or a pantry.
Oh, thank you. Yes. I'm in the utility room, I guess. The room for all things.
And especially for live streaming.
Yeah. I mean, for now, this is the number one position. It may change. We'll see what happens.
I love it. I think it's beautiful. Do you know, I first saw you when I was 16, and it was I went with a friend of mine took me as a 16-year-old kid to the comedy theater to go and watch Rent. And I did not know the show, and I didn't really know that many shows, but we sat there on the marble out the front on the stairs and waited in line for 3 hours to get those $25 front row tickets. And that show changed my life. And I think
many other people. My life too, pretty much.
Absolutely. You played Mark.
I did.
And
it's a long time ago. We won't go into the age gap between you and me, considering you were 16 then. Oh, no, it's not too bad.
Not too bad. Hey.
6 years or something. Oh, that's all right. Actually, I feel a bit better now that I've worked that out. I played Mark. It was an amazing experience. It was an amazing show.
It's inspired so many people in our generation, and it's incredible that here we are all these years on and you're in Billy Elliot. And congratulations to you in that. It was such a strong show. I actually saw it the day before. It was the second last day, actually, and we all knew that there was this thing looming, and who knew what was going to happen.
Yes, it was a very strange period, and like Jamie said earlier, well, he didn't even know he was doing his last show. I at least sort of had the kind of vague notion that this may be it. So, you know, not that it changed your performance, but it changed the weighting of. Oh yeah, actually, now that I think about it. Yeah, some of the lines were particularly poignant in that final show, which made it difficult, in the moment. But
yeah, of course. And you're singing a song tonight that is in a bit of a different context, but I'm so looking forward to hearing it. You're singing from Wicked?
Me too. Yeah, I'm singing As Long As You're Mine from Wicked, which is a duet. But the wonderful Jack Earl, who I'm going to make sure this screen works, he'll come up on there in a second. He's done a little cheeky arrangement to make it, you know, just for me. And I'm singing it live from my cupboard.
I'm excited. Well, go for it, mate. All the best.
All right. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Kiss me too fiercely, hold me too tight. I need help believing you're with me tonight. My wildest dreams could not foresee lying beside you, with you wanting me. And just for this moment, as long as you're mine, I've lost all resistance. I'll cross some borderline, and if it turns out it's over too fast, I'll make every last moment last, as long as you're mine. Maybe I'm brainless, maybe I'm wise, but you've got me seeing through different eyes. Somehow I've fallen under your spell, and somehow I'm feeling it's so hard that I fell. Every moment, as long as you're mine, I'll wake up my body and make up for lost time. Say there's no future for us as a pair. Oh, I may know I don't care, just for this moment, as long as you're mine. Come be how you want to. See how bright we shine. Borrow the moonlight until it is through. And now I'll be here holding you, holding you.
Justin Smith, they found you hiding in the pantry.
They did.
You have found yourself a new party piece, mate. That was gorgeous.
Thank you.
Wow. And to Jack Earl, what an arrangement. You sound stunning singing it. Gosh, just beautiful. Hey, mate, thank you so much for being with us tonight. Thanks for dropping.
Thanks, that's great. Thanks, guys.
Bless you, mate. Let us see who else is about to drop in. Oh, we have a duet, and not just any duet, but two of my very, very dearest friends. I'm talking about Mr. Joe Kosky and Ms. Alana Tranter. Hey, guys.
Hello. Hello, Jimmy C.
Hey, James.
Hey, I've missed you, mugwumps.
Oh, I miss you too, mate.
Whereabouts are you guys doing ISO?
In Kensington. Kensington, Melbourne.
Oh, we're actually a lot closer than I thought we were.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're in Kensington as well.
11:59 tomorrow night, I'll pop around. I'll bring four of my
I can't wait.
Now, you guys have obviously both been doing shows kind of almost back-to-back over the last sort of while, and it hasn't really given you guys much of a chance to live or be together.
Correct.
No, we haven't spent this much time together in probably our whole relationship, which has been for a couple of years.
Yeah. Have you been learning things about each other, like, you know, each other's middle names or, you know, whatever?
Yeah, each other's middle names. Yeah, we got that far.
Yeah. Okay, tick. Yeah, good. So obviously, Joe, you and I were doing School of Rock.
Yeah.
And before that, you had Kinky Boots happening and Priscilla happening. And Alana, you were smashing it in Come From Away. What a talented pair you guys are.
Thank you.
Oh, stop.
But now, you know, while all of us are talking about needing to connect with each other and you know, find a way to find togetherness, we get you guys together. It's like the silver lining of this whole story.
Yeah, I'm sure everyone's thrilled that we get time together. You're welcome.
You guys are public enemy number one right now.
Yeah.
No, I'm so excited for you guys. I'm excited that you've been forced to have time together. I'm excited that, you know, we can celebrate togetherness and it's lovely to see you guys having such great careers, and I just want the best for both of you moving forwards, and I really hope that, you know, when this industry comes back, and I'm sure people are going to be wanting you guys, you'll be in demand because you're both very, very talented.
Well, I've heard there's talk of a California Dreaming reunion tour when this is all over, James, so.
I've been rehearsing my midnight voyage. I'm ready, James.
Are you going to call up Rachel Dunham and Michelle Brasier?
I'll get them involved. You know it.
Right.
You know it. Guys, you are singing one of my absolute all-time favorite Stephen Schwartz songs from one of my favorite all-time favorite Stephen Schwartz musicals from Children of Eden. I'm just going to hand over to you guys. You can go and do your thing.
Let's do it.
Beautiful.
In whatever time we have, for as long as we are living, we can face whatever comes. If we face it now as one, I can face it on my own. Let me know that I don't have to. No one really wants to be alone. In whatever time we have, at times we are afraid, with so little to believe in, it's all right to be afraid. I will hold you in the dark. All we know for sure is this: though the world could end tomorrow, you and I will be together in whatever time
we have, for as long as we are living, we can face whatever comes. If we face it now as one,
we won't yield. You'll be my fortress and I will be your shield.
No one really wants to be alone. Whatever time we have, there are times I've been afraid. In a world that's so uncertain, then I feel your hand in mine, and there's courage in my heart.
We could live 100 years,
or the world could end tomorrow, but we know we'll be together in whatever time. From this day forward, nights won't seem so black. From this day forward, we will never look back. In whatever time we have, make the most of
time.
We'll be together.
You guys, that was just gorgeous. That was so good.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Just beautiful. Oh,
appreciate it.
Give me your guitar fingers, please.
They're yours.
Alana, give me that voice.
Oh, okay.
That's awesome. Thank you so much, guys. I mean, the song is just so meaningful. Always has been, but I feel like it just takes a whole new meaning now. We're talking about unity and, you know, it's really powerful stuff.
It sure is, mate.
So thank you.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you. Enjoy the rest of your night.
You too.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
We're well and truly on the home stretch now. Just a couple more acts to go. And Clee Morgan is now in the house. And Clee, where are you? I want to see your face.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good, but I'm rubbish at this technical stuff. I got busted by the host and it got cut off because I did it too early.
Oh, that's all right. We never trained in this.
I should not be doing these things. That's all I can say.
It is amazing watching people upskill, you know. my mum's a 60-something-year-old kindergarten teacher and she's like learning like tech and she knows more than me now. And like we are really just taking the world by storm with our tech, you know, small steps, but we're getting there, aren't we?
Real little baby steps. I'm so amazing. Nervous, James.
Dude, don't. You're just singing. This is you and me singing to each other. I'll sing first. And
just
you can...
us.
Yeah, dude. We worked together in Parade. I met you in doing Parade. You've done Hairspray, Matilda, Harry Potter and the Cursed Child. You have been busy.
Yeah, very lucky. Very lucky.
And now you have plenty of time with your beautiful family.
It's really nice, actually, just to stop for a second. You know, turn the news off for a minute and stop. It's nice.
It's sort of the silver lining in all of this, isn't it? We're forced to just, you know, be still and be quiet.
Yeah.
And listen and return to a sort of more wholesome time in many ways.
Totally. Yeah.
You are going to sing.
Home. I've got my pajamas on right now. I just on the bottom half.
Do you?
Top half is
come on.
TV studio. Bottom half, home.
Yeah, I'm exactly the same. Totally.
Thought so.
I hear you. You are going to sing my all-time favorite Stephen Schwartz song, which is Beautiful City.
Yeah, I did Godspell and I was lucky enough to hear this song each night and always wanted to sing it. So this is beautiful and apt for the time.
It absolutely is very, very apt. All right, well, I'm not going to hold us up. Let's let Clee Morgan perform Beautiful City.
Faith is all but killed. you can give up, bitter and battered, or you can slowly start to be. But finally, a city of men. We can build a city of men, yeah. We can build, we can build, we can build, we can build.
Sorry, I had to cough in the middle.
Clean.
I haven't sung in like a year and a half.
And that was just stunning. Cough
in front
and
of all my peers.
Clee, you can cough for me any day of the week.
Thanks,
was amazing.
James.
It was just gorgeous. No, thank you, Clee.
Thank you for having me.
So stunning. Guys, we're so close to the end now. We just want to show you a really quick and really important message. This video comes from the president of MEAA, Chloe Delamore.
Josh texting now. He should be getting the next person ready. Hi, guys. Oh my gosh, how awesome was that? Oh, far out. I have had the best time. In all seriousness, how incredible that in this seriously bewildering time, everyone is coming up with new ways of doing things. It's what we're best at. We're agile. We always survive. We bring joy. Congratulations to everyone tonight. And we're going to get through this. Tonight is just an example of how on the front foot our industry is. We've already got streaming agreements happening with the live theatre companies. This is going to be an amazing time where innovative new ideas come out of a really shit time. But onwards and upwards, here's just so many more nights like tonight. Thank you so much for continuing to bring such joy, for your support, for your union. If you're not a member, we've got a new member deal. But seriously, you're all amazing. Can't wait to see you in a theatre foyer soon. Cheers.
Thank you, Chloe Delamore. That was great. There's just so much hope and joy that comes, that just exudes from every part of her. She's wonderful. Thank you for that message. It really is so important to be uplifted during this time. We really appreciate it. All right. Now we have Georgie Hopson and Monique Salle. Get in here, guys. Georgie and Mon. Hey, dudes.
Hi. How's it going?
We got another twosome.
Yeah. Woo. What a cracker of a night this has been.
It has been just so good, hasn't it?
Everybody is exceptional. Exceptional.
Amazing. I just feel like I found that, you know, there's been so much angst lately and you know, we're hoping that tonight's a joyful night, but gosh, it's just, everything's just sort of released, hasn't it? And we've just had so much wonder and happiness. throughout the night. Everyone has been so generous with performing, and I don't know the last time that either of you sang, but well, probably in rehearsal earlier, hey?
Literally, this has been such good like motivator to keep singing, because like, you know, ISO life, you're just relaxing on the couch all day, so it's been nice to have something to like work towards.
Exactly. Now Mon, you were performing in Shrek, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
And Georgie, you were about to perform in Merrily We Roll Along.
Yes, yeah, Merrily, and then
Secret Garden as well, so you had a couple of things lined up. And so now suddenly you guys have all this time to hang out together.
Yeah. It's actually the most time we've spent together in a long time, because we usually do like city. So that's been nice for us, yeah, actually. Good. Very handy. If we don't, she doesn't kill me first. A lot of time to redecorate the house. The house is looking amazing.
You know, you've done very well. And I hope it's not just limited to like what we can see in the background. I hope you're really cleaning up everywhere.
Oh, yeah. Don't you worry. The cupboards are so organized.
One of the best things about ISO is time to work on all those home projects. Georgie, congratulations on your Green Room award.
Thank you.
Your lead role as Mother in Ragtime. And what a performance. It was just magnificent.
Thank you. Thanks so much. It was such a nice little kind of isolation high for me to like sit down. We had like, we're on the couch in our trackies watching the awards. It was the most comfortable I've ever been at an award ceremony, which was lovely. And it was such like, it was so amazing to hear my name called out. That was really cool, and like a little nice positive spin on this time. And so cool that I got like won an award next to Anthony Wallow. So that was surreal.
That's not bad, is it?
Who? Right? Like,
some guy. I know. And what are you guys doing to keep motivated while you're in ISO?
Things like this.
What else? A bit of yoga. A bit of yoga with Adrian.
Yes. Yoga with Adrian, 30 days. That is every day. It's so good.
It's free. YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah. Are we plugging? Nice.
Yeah. Send us money, Adrian.
it's hard to say. Cleaning. So much cleaning. That's our
I know. What all of us should be doing, right? Now, you guys are no pressure, but you are about to perform a song that has been famous the world over, from Prince of Egypt, and was recently performed online with Cynthia Erivo and Shoshana Bean. I'm talking, of course, of There Can Be Miracles When You Believe.
Yes, indeed.
No pressure. No pressure.
No pressure, but who is your accompanist tonight?
Some guy who's like trying to get his start in the industry. I think you might know his name. Stephen Schwartz has put down our backing track for us. Thank you, Joshua Robson.
Thank you, Josh Robson.
Thank you to Stephen Schwartz. This is insane. So as we hear the most beautiful voices in harmony, we're also going to hear the delicate feather-light fingers of Stephen Schwartz. Guys, mwah, give us our second last song for the night. Please go for it.
When
Georgie Hobson, Monsal. Guys, that was just exquisite.
Thank you for the track starting again. Steven, stop.
The prize, yes. Guys, thank you so much. Wow.
Thank you so much.
Have a beautiful rest of your night. Mwah. It really has been an incredible night. I want to just announce something I think is pretty exciting, which is that we have hit the box office records for online live theater productions with cast members affected by COVID. We have raised, thanks to your generosity, over $10,000 in box office, which is incredible, an incredibly specific niche category. But it's completely overwhelming. Thank you so very much for your generosity. All of this money is going to be shared between all the people who have been involved in putting on tonight's show. And you've seen them all tonight. Most of them, there's a whole bunch of them also working backstage, and we really are so, so grateful. We are going to be keeping the GoFundMe campaign open longer when this is over. So just because we end our Facebook Live broadcast does not mean that the GoFundMe campaign ends as well. So you still have time to get back in there once the show's over and to buy your ticket. We are, again, so incredibly grateful. Now we have one final item this evening. A young man by the name of Todd McKenney, who I have never met. So he must be one of the new kids, but that's okay. He deserves to be here just as much as the rest of us. Todd McKenney.
Hello.
How you doing, Todd?
I'm good. How are you? Thank you for that introduction. I loved it.
You're so welcome. I was going to change my shirt. I was going to have a much louder sort of Boy from Oz inspired shirt, but I just didn't have time, and I wasn't too enraptured by There Can Be Miracles When You Believe.
Well, I've done that myself. This is the jacket. Do you know what? This is a really good lesson for all you young players out there, that if you can get away with it, you should always pinch something from every show that you do, because you just never know when you're going to need it. So this is my jacket from when I played Teen Angel in Greece, which I nicked. This is my cane from Anything Goes, which I nicked. This is my Oscar from Boy from Oz, which I nicked. And I'll do a smart costume change at the end of this, and that's my Act One finale from Boy from Oz, Boy from Oz costume. So nick what you can, kids. And if John Frost is watching this, I'm in deep shit.
I was wondering if you'd nicked maybe like the dog from Annie as well.
I've got a couple of those out the back, yeah, ready to go.
Yeah, good. You know, the night that I was there was no dog. The show went on, and the moment where Sandy's supposed to walk on stage, there was no dog. And poor Annie and the cop just looked at each other baffled as the underscore went for, I don't know, 64 bars or something, and kind of mumbled. And there's that whole scene, you know, with a call over the dog, calling by his name. And they just had to stand there.
Sandy.
Yeah, there was no Sandy.
When I saw Annie in the production before the one that I did with Chloe Dallimore and Nancy and Anthony, the dog came on for its very first entrance, and I don't know what had happened, but it slipped, and so it just stood centre stage, and all four paws went in every direction. And you know what? It brought the house down. So I've been trying to have a dog in every single performance that I do, because it's a crowd pleaser.
Absolutely. Just make sure that floor is well oiled and just send that thing out there.
Yeah, totally.
Absolutely. Well, there's no oil on your floor tonight, hopefully.
No, there's not. I've got some other, but they're not dogs though, but I've got the Todd McKenney Orchestra. We thought we'd give you a big finish.
Yeah, this is a big finish for sure. I mean, your legs are half the appeal.
Thank you.
Todd, I'm also noticing you guys are like fully like respecting the social distancing limits. Like, you've really spaced yourself out in all four corners.
Yeah, we've got the broom of social distancing. This broom is 1.5 meters exactly from bristle to tip. So you can see that we're very safe.
Now, you got room for arm gestures.
So Ralph and Lisa are married, so they're allowed to be intimately close. And Michael behind me, as you can see, we are legal distance. This is Michael Roenick on this old Bechstein piano here. And so we're legal.
Good. You just keep that broom faced right at him, just in case he has to like do any sudden reaches to the top end of the piano, all right?
Yeah, back, boy. Back.
I was wondering if you'd like left room for in center stage for some dancing, but you got a chair with some sort of ubiquitous cushions. Just
yeah, we do. We have the this comes from my Todd McKenney Sings Peter Allen show. I stole that, but I did pay for it. That's a parrot, and I've got a couple of homemade scorecards that people who have come and watched musicals I've been in have brought and then handed to me nearly at every show after the show. So that was a 10, so I did okay that night.
But I can see that they've whited out the zero just in case they want to highlight one digit rather than both.
Yeah, well, a 10 is just a 1 with a zero next to it, isn't it?
If you hold it up the wrong way, absolutely.
Oh, no, this one's an 11. This person gave me 11, but the same thing, I think your premise is right because you can still easily make that just a 1.
Or Roman numerals and it's a 2.
Yeah, and it's on a fly swat.
I mean, that's ingenious.
Yeah, it's fabulous. It's absolutely fabulous. So I've been watching your concert. It's been going great.
It's been going so great. I mean, we've had such a night of joy and hope and you know, hearing the stories. And yeah, the stories are, you know, grey and murky, but the silver lining is there. You know, the message is clear. We're going to come back from this.
Yeah, no, we will. And I think the thing that's come out of tonight's concert is the heart, and is the heart that we as performers have in what can often be a really tricky business. But more often than not, it's a really uplifting and joyous and special business. And because of the heart that we all put into every single time we get on stage, that's why we'll bounce back and bigger than ever, you know.
We have so many stories that we are left to tell. And I think that is a good segue into your song, Todd.
Yeah, it is. So this is from Pippin. It's magic to do, and I've learnt most of the lyrics. Let's go. Michael and Jimmy, who you can't see. Jimmy provided our lighting, so we pinched most of this lighting from Ark.
Good, are you going to nick that one too? Guys, thank you so much. Todd, you're a wonder as always. What a showman. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you all. Thanks everyone for the supporting the arts. And I hope to meet you one day.
Absolutely. We'll make it happen.
Okay.
Just don't steal from me. Guys, that is our final performance for this evening. And it really has been just a night of highlights. And finishing off with Todd McKenney and that message of we have got magic to do just tells us exactly how much unfinished business there is for us in the performing arts, and we have no idea. We're taking it day by day. We have no idea how long this will be the situation for us, but as long as we have air in our lungs and music, beautiful music to sing, we are going to keep performing. We're going to be alive and kicking and do what we can. We have some thank yous that we absolutely must make mention of tonight. We need to first of all say how indebted we are to Stephen Schwartz, who has just been so generous, obviously giving us access to his whole catalogue of music. He's been so generous in recording the track for Georgie and Mon to sing When You Believe. He's just been wonderful from the get-go. So thank you to Stephen Schwartz, to Zoe Frangos for our graphics, Alex Wales, legend, for our video content, to Ian Phipps, who got the word out there for us tonight and did so much work for us, to all of our accompanists and musicians who gave up their time to record backing tracks for our artists and to be present on the night, to John Frost, Lord Tripokey, Lisa Campbell, Luke Joslin, Harriet Snaith, and all those from Carey Grammer, including Tim Schwert. Thank you guys for your contributions. To Jason Beauvais, the Managing Director of Moving Light Productions Australia, legendary. We have Stacey Louise Camilleri, and I need to take time to say her name very carefully because you must remember her. She's a legend. Stacey Louise Camilleri for being our sound technician, Jason Glass and Elise Glass, who are our tech supervisor and stage manager, respectively. We need to thank all of our brilliant artists who, despite all of this mayhem, continue to provide us with joy and hope and in a brand new, crazy, complicated format of a different version of live entertainment. Thank you all for sharing with us tonight. And lastly, to our viewers, you people, you fine people out there in the dark, sitting on your couches, enduring your own complicated stories right now. We thank you so much that you popped in for a bit or for the whole night. Either way, that you stuck around and were here with us. Thank you for your generous support tonight. Your voices and your donations are what keeps the art alive, not just today, but forever. We thank you so much for giving so generously to the arts industry. And I don't just mean tonight. I mean always. You allow us to continue doing what we do, and we can't wait to get back and give back to you all the more. As I said, the thank yous, the Lights Up on the Arts GoFundMe page is still going to be open, so you can still rush out and buy your tickets. And Josh, I want to throw over to you, mate, because what an incredible night this has been, and such a huge thanks to you from Joshua Robson Productions for producing this entire event.
Thanks, James. Yeah, we're very stoked with how that turned out. I mean, it was bound to run not so smoothly, and because we had all the right people on board and we had everyone in their place as they were meant to be, as per any usual live production, we were really lucky to have a great group that made this run so smoothly tonight. I'm very grateful for everyone that you just thanked, including yourself. Thank you for putting in all the hard yards and basically coaching us through this evening and introducing and spotlighting each of those performers that we had and what they've been through individually. I mean, we're pivoting as an industry. We need to adapt as an industry and as artists and creatives and crew members. Everyone involved in our industry need to pivot. And I think this is probably the direction. We were so set on making sure that we included this live element, because that is the thrill that we all seek as performers and producers and creatives and crew members. We seek that live thrill where something might go wrong, something could happen, but it also could go perfectly. And tonight we were really lucky that it went almost perfectly. I mean, we almost lost Doug there for a second, but like in the movie The Hangover, we found him and we gave him a best friend hug, and we got there at the end of the day. We're really lucky that we have such a great industry that's so willing to give up their time and effort to pivot and change. And we really need our audiences to do the same. We really need our audiences to go, in this next year, this is probably what's going to happen. We're actually going to have to get our theater and our live entertainment from this online medium. And we're happy to give it to you if you're happy to receive it. And thank you for spending that money on the tickets tonight. We're incredibly grateful for what you've given. We're almost at 11 grand in donations from everyone that's bought their ticket tonight. So thank you so much. That'll go split evenly between everyone who's been involved in putting this evening on. Thanks, James. I'll throw back to you. From me and the team here, the tech team here. Yeah. Woo-hoo. Jace loves being on camera. But yeah, thanks everyone. And if this happens again, stay tuned on my Facebook page and hopefully we can bring you another one in the near future.
That's absolutely right, Josh. Thanks, mate. Congratulations to you. Thanks, look, mate. You mentioned the word pivot, and we know about this thing called pandemic pivots. So as we wrap up tonight, I want to share with you, everyone who's listening and watching, just some of the things that are going on right now while our creatives are not able to be on stage. The things they're doing to keep themselves entertained and sane and all those good things. We have the Isolate Late Show. We'd love you to support them. Lock down and stay up every Friday night with the Isolate Late Show, an online live concert event raising money for Australia's creative workforce. Each Friday, pop on your fancy PJs and tune in for a live concert direct to your lounge room, hosted by Green Room Award winner Naomi Price from Ladies in Black, Luke Kennedy from Swing On This and The Voice Australia, Jason McGregor from Lady Beetle and Rumour Has It, and weekly special guests. You can catch it live every Friday night at 8 p.m. Via www.theisolatelateshow.com. Next up is the Social Dis Dance Project, emphasis on the word dance, the Social Dis Dance Project, which is an online community connecting dance artists through creativity and movement. The Social Dis Dance Project currently exists as a training platform for dancers, professional through to social dancers, to attend classes at a pay as you can rate. The donations go toward the running of the project and to the teachers and the artists for their time. It was created to connect community through creativity and movement, providing opportunities. We would love you to support them as well. For more information, you can sign up to any classes. Head to Instagram at socialdis_dance. Remotely Funny is another pandemic pivot that's going on right now. It's the quarantined comedy show that is now airing. It's a real variety comedy show with incredible guest artists each episode. They are keeping audiences entertained during lockdown and giving artists an outlet and supportive audience base for their material. It's created to show support for the Melbourne International Comedy Festival, which provides financial support, the fund, which supports staff and crew, front of house, etc., who lost work, obviously, due to the cancellation of this year's festival. They also promote support for the individual artists and the acts that appear on the show too. Episodes are airing regularly on their dedicated YouTube channel. To continue, Remotely Funny does need your original submissions. So they're looking for 3 to 5 minute acts, of the comedy genre, of course, and everyone is encouraged to apply for that. See facebook.com/remotelyfunny for details, or you can email them at goobaproductions@gmail.com for further info. We also have the Isola Project. Many songwriters, one musical, out of isolation. The Isola, I-S-O-L-A, Project has gathered songwriters from all over Australia and has asked them to write one single song using the themes of connection, isolation, and unity. These songs are then going to be put together into a musical. They will form a brand new original musical. Songwriters have submitted their pieces and are now in the process of, or they're now in the hands of the scriptwriter, Shaz Mullins, and myself as creative director, whose task it is to bring them together into a unified piece. The hope is that at some point down the track, possibly via live stream, we will be able to present the musical to you so that people everywhere can appreciate it and experience it. Through these projects, of course, we're being reminded that no matter who we are or where we are all connected through the unifying powers of music and of comedy, especially in these very isolating times. If you want to follow the Isola Project, jump on Facebook, look up the Isola Project page, and you can track the progress there. Finally, we've got the Sunday Picture Club, which has formerly been known as Apocalypse Portraits. Now, you may well be aware of this. You might have participated yourself. These guys are hilarious. It was created by Wade Briggs and Scott Brownlee. As I said, formerly Apocalypse Portraits. It's now called the Sunday Picture Club. These guys inspire us all around the world with themes, and they ask us to capture the theme in a single, in photographic images. Some of the previous themes have included glamour filth, Bowie's in space, jungle royalty, tea party for toys, imaginary mate, trash bag realness. These guys are serious about their photography. You can follow them on Instagram at the Sunday Picture Club and get involved. Guys, that is just a small sample of what's going on. I would implore you to trawl Facebook and Instagram and share with each other all the wonderful things people are doing as their pandemic pivot projects. Please get involved in supporting more and more as you go. We thank you once again for tonight. It has been an incredible night. That GoFundMe link will still be open after the show, so you can jump on there and just go crazy. All right, go nuts. Thank you all. Thank you so much for being with us tonight. And now you can go and watch MasterChef, because I'm sure it'll be up now on 10 Play. Good night, guys. Please support the arts as always. Mwah. Bye-bye.